Hello, welcome to this new video tutorial. Today I'm going to quickly show you how to perform the JDBC connection to MySQL using Spring Boot. In order to achieve that, we are going to create a simple, you will need a MySQL database. Here I'm using phpMyAdmin, I've already installed it, and here you can see MySQL is running under the port 3306, and here we have one database called Spring Boot with a table student having three attributes: student ID, names, programs, and some data are already in it. So, and another thing to remember here is the user that we are going to use. We are going to use this Spring Boot user. So that's it. Let's start. Let's get started. So regarding our program, our roadmap is as follows. We have one main class, a domain class, two interfaces, one student data access object, and one student service class. Interface, and two implementation of those interfaces. Now let us create our project. So we go to, we are going to use this Spring SES IDE tool. So Eclipse, and now let's create a new project. We go to Spring Starter Projects, start our projects, call Hello MySQL. Next, here you are going to select web, it's there, then JDBC that we have here, and then last is the web that is already selected. So you have selected JDBC, web, and MySQL. These are the three package that dependencies that we have selected. Here is our project that is created, and that's going to be populated by Maven. Here is our main class. So here is our main class, and what we need now is a domain class. Create our student class. Student. And these fields are going to correspond with what we have here in this table, the attribute that we have in this table. So here we have integer, student ID, then we have string, name, and last we have string, program. Then we need some setters and getters. For our three attributes. Then last is we are going to insert the string. Here is our string method that is generated. So right now we have our student domain class that is ready. Then next is next our two objects. We need to create one interface called student.dao. And we also need to create another interface for our student. Then here we go. Now we need another class called DAO implementation. Student Z. Implementation, and the last is the class student service implementation. So all our classes that we need are ready. Now we need to put the content of our interface. So in order to make the tutorial short, I have prepared some sample code. Here we have the content of our DAO here. We have three methods here. Insert a student, get student, and list student. So we need to insert the list from Java utility. Here is our data access object. Then we need our service. So our student service interface will have three method declaration. Insert a student, get student by ID, and then get all student. Then after our two interfaces are ready, the service and the data object, we have now to implement our data object interface. And in order to do that one, we need we just get this one first. Our DAO implementations. Here we are extending the Java the JDBC DAO support. That's a template. And here we are importing, we are injecting the data source. You have to be aware of that. And here is the initialization of our data source. And lastly, we just perform the normal JDBC operation with insert, insertion, selections, and then listing as usual. I assume that you are already familiar with JDBC with Java. So, and lastly is the one step before the last is the implementation of our service. Here is our service implementation. So here is our student service implementation that is ready. Now we have to implement now our main class. Hello SQL two. Hello SQL two. So what we are doing right now in our main class is we are injecting our service, student service that we have here. We just inject the student service, and after having the student service now, we load initialize this context, application context, and then assign our context to our service bin. And after assigning our service, we are able, like if we just disable, for example, this one, we are going to see that here our service that we have injected is not available in this context. So what we have to do is to assign our context to the service, and after that we have access to all the methods provided by our service. And then that's it. We just write like the name is I got it, and then here is Spring Boot. This is the program. Just let's just write something like this one, and then here we want to insert the ID number 6 to get the ID number 5, something like that. Let's say 1 ID number, student ID number 1, and here we get all students. So before we run our application now, we need to go to this application properties and then put the credential for our database. And what we do is that we just take this one. Here we may want to run it on that. I just put this one here to avoid some conflict with ports, like we want to change it, not using the port 80, default port 8080, here to use on port 991, something like this one. And here is the username, the password, the database name, and here is the port that our database is running under it. And here is the name of our database with auto connection set to true. So we save the whole thing now. Go here, right click our application, run as Java application. And if everything work well, we should be able to see our data in the console. And bam, we are there. So here you can see that here we have different things that we have entered. I got it here, Spring Booter. This is the last student that we have inserted, and these are some of the pre-existing students that have been there in the database. So in this way, we have successfully connected our Spring Boot application to the MySQL database using JDBC connections. And I hope that this tutorial has been useful to you, and I will try to put this code available to the description under this YouTube channel, and also the link to my GitHub account. And if you have question, you have any question, do not hesitate to drop a comment. Stay tuned for the next tutorial on how to perform the same connect operation with MySQL using the same DJPA. See you too. Ciao.